I'm Holly Tompkins, a Senior Development Review Planner with the Department of Planning and Zoning, and we're here with another discussion on the Southern Kent Island Sanitary Project. The topic this segment is home value considerations. With me is Dick Sells, a Kent Island Estates homeowner and Eastern Shore Realtor. Welcome.
Thank you. Good morning.
I was wondering if you could please give us a little background on how you became involved and what you'd be talking about.
Sure. The Queen Anne's County staff asked me to talk about some of our experiences over the last 10 years or so with failing septic systems, and specifically to talk about the impact of failing septic systems on property value. As I am a realtor and a homeowner in Kent Island Estates, I've experienced quite a bit of the history of failing septic systems in both parts of my life. I will say to start with that these are my personal views and not to be attributed to any organization that I may be a part of. My wife Kathy and I have lived in Kent Island Estates for nearly 17 years and have been realtors serving buyer and seller clients here on the shore since 2004. We've represented numerous buyer and seller clients where failing septic systems were an issue. And we've worked with the Environmental Health Department, contractors, and these buyers and sellers to resolve problems so that sales could be completed. In our community, we've experienced quite a few challenges with failing septic systems, and we upgraded our own home's septic system to a Maryland-approved best available technology system when they came out in 2006. That said, for more than 25 years in our community, there have been discussions about providing a sewer collection system down Route 8 to resolve the continuing septic problems. And it seems like the current Southern Kent Island project is moving toward maybe a final solution for this long-term problem. The holding tank policy implemented earlier this year has severely tightened the inspection standards for septic systems passing in those inspections. It requires that the groundwater be no higher than 24 inches below ground surface in order to meet this high water table threshold. If it doesn't meet that, the system will be failed, and the county may require the home to be hooked up to a holding tank and disconnected from its septic drain field. Many, if not most, of the homes on Southern Kent Island are not likely to meet this 24-inch standard.
What effect on property value does this have?
I'll answer that by talking about property value first and what it really means, because people in the real estate business think of property value in one way, homeowners think of it slightly another way, and potential buyers maybe even a different way. Property value in general is usually defined as, or referred to as, fair market value. And fair market value simply is the estimated price a buyer and a seller could agree on if they were both interested in making a deal. So one could say you really don't know what the fair market value is until a deal is done, but that's what appraisers and realtors do in trying to estimate the fair market value to assist buyers and sellers in making real estate deals. So, a buyer and a seller need information. The definition assumes that both parties have sufficient information about the market and the property, and that the property has been on the market for a reasonable time before the definition really turns into a fair market value number. The information on both sides can either be positive or negative, and the market value, the fair market value, moves up or down in response. Therefore, a deal is struck when both parties are comfortable enough with the information they have to make a decision. information about a home septic system is a critical piece in any sale transaction. And in some cases, determines whether the home may even be occupied by current residents. In the process of a sale, there's virtually always a septic system inspection. Most lenders require it. The only time that we see people waiving septic inspections are on cash deals where the buyer is willing to take a risk. During that inspection, if the septic system fails the inspection by a professional inspector, it'll need to be repaired or replaced, often at a cost of $10,000 to $20,000, before a sale can settle. That comes right off the seller's sale proceeds. Needs to be advanced sometimes before they get to the settlement. If the Environmental Health Department does not permit the septic system to be repaired, the home may be disconnected from the field and a holding tank installed. That is a tough sentence on a homeowner. Estimated costs for installation of a holding tank, I think, are somewhere in the range of $6,000 to $8,000, and the frequent pump out service of maybe $4,000 to $5,000 to $6,000 a year would be a continuing expense. Some of these holding tanks, where they're installed, need to be pumped every couple of weeks. The prospect for of that future expense could likely discourage a buyer from purchasing that home unless there's a reasonable prospect of future sewer service. So buyers are accepting a certain amount of risk in any sale transaction or any purchase transaction, but they're assuming some uncertain risk when it's not really clear how the septic system issue is going to be resolved in the future. And uncertain risk causes buyers to be cautious and may push them away from even making the purchase to start with. The bottom line is that buyers need to be informed and comfortable with the information they have about a property before being willing to make an offer. Potential cost of septic system repairs, and particularly the possibility of holding tank requirement, are big uncertainties. As long as those uncertainties exist, there will be uncertainty about property values.
Thank you for coming and sharing this information about property value considerations. Please check out all the video segments on the Southern Kent Island Sanitary Project at the county's website at www.qac.org. Also, please make sure to attend the public information workshop on December 19th at the Kent Island High School from 7 to 10 p.m., where you'll be able to review the maps, understand more about the ordinance, speak with staff, the agency officials, and your county commissioners. Thank you.